Hello and welcome to my air fuel mixture setup video. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing of the Gunson Colortune. We'll get into that straight away. Let's have a quick look at the box. So, contents of the box. We've got the Colortune plug itself, cross-section gas seal, the extension HT lead, a cleaning brush, the view scope that comes in two parts, and the instructions. Quick look at the back. It's a bit of guidance on what we're looking for. So, in summary, if we have a yellow flame coming from the engine, that's indicating a rich fuel mixture with a high fuel consumption. And a blue flame indicating that we're at our maximum economy. This chart here, just running through that same principle. So let's have a look in the box. Okay, so we've got a set of instructions. The Gunson Colortune handbook. And the device itself. So here we have the HT extension bar. Wire cleaning brush. The two-piece view scope. This end fits over the Colortune, and this bit just slides over there with a mirror on the end, just so you can see, get it into awkward angles and see the flame or the colour of the flame. Fitting plug. And the Colortune spark plug itself. As you can see there, we have the glass insert allowing us to see inside the bore while the engine's running, and the brass seal. So we're going to be using this kit on a CVH 1.6. It's been upgraded with a pair of DCNF Weber Twin 40s. Next we'll get on to setting up the Colortune itself and moving on to adjusting the air fuel mixture. Okay, so before we get into fitting the actual Colortune spark plug, a quick look around the engine bay. We've got the RS1600i rocker cover. Standard exhaust manifold, hoping to upgrade to a four branch very soon. Here we have the twin DCNF Weber Twin 40s with the twin cane ends sitting on the top. Moving round, here's our fuel regulator. Currently set to 3 bar, and our facet fuel pump. This is a temporary fit just while we do a test. As you can see here, I've just got a wire going directly to the live just for the purposes of our test. Now we'll get on to fitting the actual Colortune spark plug. Okay then, some things to note before we fit the spark plug. Always ensure we have the brass washer to ensure we have our seal, and as stated in the instructions, do not over tight this spark plug, hand tight only. So let's move on to the engine. We're going to remove spark plug 1. Okay. Now I've taken this car for a quick test drive and she does seem to be misfiring slightly and is a little bit flat, so hopefully this air fuel mixture tune should resolve those problems. As we can see on there, quite a bit of soot indicating we are over fueling slightly. Now let's fit the colour tune spark plug. Ready to go in. Now again, always remember, do not over tighten the colour tune. Finger tight only. Next step is to fit our extension HT lead bar. Just screws onto the end of the spark plug. Again, not too tight, don't want to cross thread this. And then we just put the HT lead onto the end of the extension bar. And now we're ready to fire up the engine. The installation is as easy as that. One more thing actually. For the purposes of the video, I'll fit the view scope. Not that we necessarily need to here, as we can clearly see the colour tune spark plug, but if we remove the HT lead, here's our view scope. So we'll take the mirror section off and just fit the lower section. So over the top of the HT lead extension, and that should clip onto the spark plug, if you can see. Now this end has a cutout, so this is where the HT extension bar will run outside of the tube. Hopefully you can see this okay. So now the tube is fitted over the end. You can see the HT lead extension bar runs outside of the tube. And now we have our mirror. Looking down at the colour, once the engine is running. So let's not forget to put the HT lead back on. Okay. Now we're ready to fire the engine up and see what colour we have inside the chamber. Okay then, so let's fire up the car. And see what colour we have. As you can see there, we have a bright orange flame, indicating that we're running far too rich. So the next steps is to adjust the air fuel mixture on the back of the car, and we're looking to achieve a bright blue flame. Let's give it a quick rev. Okay then, I've had a little mess around with the air fuel mixture. And as you can see, now we've lost the spark. Okay, let's try this again. I think we've got it now. Just fire up the engine. Okay, so we've got a nice blue on tick over. Now, let's give her a rev. Hopefully we won't lose the spark this time. Okay. One last little run. So we're keeping our blue spark. Now we're going to try setting up the other carb. We're going to move the colour tune, to cylinder number 4. Okay then, as you can see here, the colour tune has been fitted into spark plug or cylinder chamber number 4. I've fitted the view scope mirror as well. We're going to fire up the engine now, see what colour we've got. Nope. Turn on the fuel pump first. Here we go. Okay then, as you can see there, slightly blue but slightly yellow flame. It's not looking too bad actually. Let's give her a rev. Testing. As you can see, we've got a blue flame. So that's looking a little bit better. Okay then, so in summary, we removed spark plug 1, fitted the colour tune, we removed all of the orange and we've got a nice blue flame, cylinder number 1. We could check cylinder number 2, which we probably will do after a test drive, but we'll just assume that that's okay for the moment. We've checked cylinder number 4. That's running a nice blue flame now through the rev range. Again, we'll assume the same for cylinder number 3. Next, we'll take it for a test run, see how she's running. massive loss of power.
Okay, just pulling back up now.
Okay, then drawing this video to conclusion now. I've checked all four sparks. They're all running a blue flame throughout the rev range. I've been messing around doing runs in this for the past 2 hours. It's still running flat between 4,000 and 6,000. Not sure what the issue is. If you've got any ideas, drop them in the comments. If you like the video, please like and favourite. I'll come back to you with a new vid soon once we've got this thing sorted. Goodbye.